evenly. God!
Hello everybody, welcome to the Two Man Advantage Podcast. It's Fantasy Football Friday, boys. I should say Wednesday. Friday, it's Wednesday. Correct me if I'm wrong.
You are wrong.
I'm a couple days off, that's alright. So, recap of last week. DK, what the hell happened?
I lost. God, DJ picked up, like, I remember him saying, Superman, I'll take
Superman.
Him. And I don't know, Delanie Walker. Those are pretty much how he quoted
Delanie
them
Walker
when he put them on his lineup.
Pretty much bend you over.
Those two, two single-handedly pretty much beat me.
Yep.
What are you going to do?
And TJ.
Damn it, I was so close to ending this up.
and TJ, obviously, you redeemed yourself after last week's performance.
I sure did with my Superman.
With your Superman.
I was actually kind of in shock when I turned on the game, and I saw that he
like I'm this he, much he, ahead.
Well, you sent me a text message and said Delanie Walker 2 TDs, and I said, oh, I forgot. I was too busy raking those my leaves, and so then I went in, I checked my thing, and did, he's got 2 TDs, and Newton's already has 2 TDs, and like this could be all right.
This is gonna be.
Then I turn on the game, and he throws another one, runs another one in. I'm like, meh, not bad.
Yeah.
I think that was a pretty good pickup.
It was a beatdown.
Mm-hmm. It was a beatdown. All right, but moving on this week, obviously there's a lot of interesting matchups out there. So we'll start with defense as DK is bobbing his head and thinking about which defense he's going to play this week. Who are you thinking, DK?
I don't know. I got a couple of them to choose from. I think there's a lot of good fantasy matchups this week.
Mm-hmm. I think, there is. But then there's some that are horrible.
There are, but there's a few that I don't know. I'm really liking. So let's go defense. Is that what we're doing first?
Defense.
Like what we always do.
Were you in championships?
All right, let me see. I got a few. When are these games being played? Okay, two defense to choose from. I think I'm gonna roll with
Green Bay against Detroit.
That would be the smart pick.
But they're too much money.
Hold on, let's see. Let's go through Darren's thought process. I don't know. They had that week off. They cleaned house. You know, this could be the week.
This is the week.
This could be the week.
I was going to say, if you're staffing, stashing Stafford on your bench, this is the week to play him.
Because why? Green Bay's coming off 2 beatdowns, exactly. And they're definitely going to take it easy on Green.
In Lambeau, what are they, 0-93 in Lambeau?
0-24. Because they haven't won since 91.
So this is the year.
This is the year.
Has got to be the year.
This is the week.
I was driving over here, and Dan Miller was on the radio with Wojo, and they had an interesting debate. What is likely to end first, the Lions losing streak in Green Bay or the Wings making consecutive playoff runs? Or making the playoffs.
Not making the playoffs?
Yeah, not making.
The Wings not making the playoffs.
That's going to end first before the Lions losing?
Yes.
To the Packers in Green Bay?
Yes.
Wow. DK, what do you think about that if you were to pick? Which ends first?
I don't give a shit about hockey, and the Lions are never going to win in Green Bay. Yeah. So I guess it would be the Red Wings.
You think about it. They couldn't beat Dan the Magic Man Mikowski when he was the quarterback in Green Bay.
Well, didn't they lose to Flynn, too?
Yeah. They lose to Flynn, and then Flynn got paid.
Flynn threw 6 touchdowns and cashed in for like $40 million.
Yeah.
Was it 24 years? Seriously?
24 since 91.
1991.
Holy 1991. Son of a...
That was the year they went to the NFC Championship game.
Wow.
So, dude, yeah. Coincidence?
Oh, God. But no, hey, you know, if you're looking for someone going to be putting up points late, because if it's going to be a blowout, Stafford might be in garbage time. Might get you.
Yeah, no.
All right. TJ, your defense.
No, he didn't pick his defense.
He just picked one now.
I just took him out.
Survey says?
I can't figure it out. I got two that I really like, so I don't know which one to go with in this, but I'm just going to go with the one that's a little cheaper.
I was going with cheap.
Give me the Steelers at home against the Browns.
The Steelers.
I was looking at them. I really was.
Like, you know what? For $4,600, and it's the Browns. Like,
Yeah, who's starting? If Manziel's starting, I love the Steelers because Manziel's horrible.
What about if Luke McCown starts?
I love the Steelers. I just don't think. I think Cleveland is horrible. I think somehow if Detroit and Cleveland played each other 16 times, both of them would end up with a losing record.
They would cancel the game. They would cancel it.
They would, yeah, I don't know how it would happen, but both of them would just continuously lose.
They would say, forget it. Let's get this over with
tonight.
There
would probably be at least four games tied at zero at the end of overtime.
We're going into
or tied at seven.
Going, yeah, one seven. We're going to quadruple overtime, yeah, tied at nine.
Nine at nine. Coming up, another punt.
And we're going college overtime. And mm-hmm. For some reason.
We are now going to flip a coin.
Both of them can't score.
It's like Celebrity Jeopardy in football. Pick a number, any
Texas
number.
With a dollar sign.
Texas with a dollar sign.
Yes. All right.
It's like your mother likes it, Trebek.
You're going with black and yellow for your mm-hmm. defense. I like that. TJ, your defense. Who are you liking?
I'm staying in the state of Pennsylvania.
Okay.
Oh, that was the two I was choosing from.
Fly Eagles fly.
Oh. That, literally, those were the two teams because I like Philly at home against Miami, too.
And Miami is, wow.
Miami's a little Jekyll Hyde.
They've been a lot of high.
I think they were on a little high when they got their new coach, and yeah. I think they're just back to what team they are.
There. Now you're seeing the real.
For Christ's sake,
Buffalo spanked them.
Yeah. Yeah,
no,
I know.
Carlos Williams spanked him.
Yeah.
Well, it doesn't matter. It's Buffalo.
Like, he's single-handedly.
All right. Okay, so you're going with the fly Eagles. Eagles fly. Fly, Eagles, fly. All right. Now, all right, so Eagles, Steelers. Let's move on to kickers. Obviously, TJ has a hard-on for Connor Barth, but we'll get back to
quite
that.
Quite expensive this week. Oh.
Gee, I wonder why. Mm-hmm. All right. DK, your kicker. Who are you liking this week?
Just going through some options here. So, I don't know.
I'm ready.
Yeah, I guess I'm just going to go Greg Zuerlein?
Question mark or yes?
No, I put him in, but question mark. Cheapest in a dome. And he kicked a 60-yarder last week. Maybe he'll do it again. I don't know.
Where is he?
Like, it's
oh, unreal. My God. He's way down
it's
there.
It's unreal how...
It's soccer, Greg. It's soccer.
It's soccer.
It's unreal how these fantasy leagues come down to kickers and defense. Yeah. And mm-hmm. we just simply sit there and go, give it a cheap one.
There's a lot mm-hmm. of times that a kicker can make and break your...
for sure.
A win, you know?
Like, who's this Jason Myers guy?
Oh, he's been kicking for Jacksonville all year?
Yeah. 4,600.
He's not bad.
Better than pick him.
DJ.
I like Greg the Leg in the dome, even though that place is getting sued now by Reggie Bush.
Yeah.
I'm sure they can afford to pay Reggie Bush's little sue.
Reggie Bush.
Reggie Bush, you're done, so I need to make money somehow.
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
Before he goes promoting a new health drink or something. Mm-hmm. TJ, you're...
Our sex tape with Kim Kardashian.
Oh, yeah.
Boom. Yeah. Shalakalaka. Who am I looking for?
Yeah, you're a kicker, sir.
Graham Gano of the Carolina Panthers.
Gano.
Against the Tennessee Titans.
I like that.
Graham Gano, 4,700.
Why do you like that?
I like Gano. Yeah. I just think he's a good player.
Like,
if I sit there and
give you reasons about why I picked Greg Zuerlein, you're like, wah, wah. And then this guy comes out and says, Greg Gano against Tennessee. I like it a lot.
I do. I have the kickers
that
I like.
Do you have a lot drop?
No, but I got...
I like it a lot.
Like we should be picking Guskowski because they're going to put up so many points.
Yeah, well...
Or so you think. I'm a little concerned about that Giants-Pats game. I think that
Why are you concerned? Are you a New England fan?
I'm a New England defense fan because that's my defense. So, but really? I don't know.
Because they're not very good.
The last 2 weeks, they put up... They only gave up 17 points in the last two games.
Yeah, Washington single-handedly gave them how many turnovers?
Still,
Giants aren't going to.
I'll
do
take
that.
It. You never know. Enough
Eli
pressure.
Eli doesn't throw interceptions.
Yeah, with enough pressure though, he can. He'll turn the ball over.
All right,
it'll cause some fumbles. All right, so your kickers are set. Let's move on to tight ends. And TJ, we'll start with you this time. Your tight end, sir.
Yeah. Not going Delaney Walker again.
Go back to the well.
Not going back to the well.
Going back to the Walker.
Not
going back.
You're not
going
to take him against Carolina? Like, no. If you think about it, it's a pretty good choice.
Carolina.
Against Tennessee, you mean?
With that defensive line, They're not going to have enough time to pass deep, and they're going to dump passes to Delaney Walker.
No.
Damn it.
Nice try. Trying to sabotage him and then taking just it,
huh? Lock it in. Go with Ebron.
No, I'm not doing
go with your boy. Didn't you buy his jersey this week?
No, that was Daily. Good evening. Daily. That was
Daily.
Good evening.
Yeah. I think Daily bought it.
Daily bought it.
Oh, because he's
chirped him.
Yeah.
No, Benjamin Watson locked in. Bang, New Orleans Saints.
Oh, my. Oh, my. Mm-hmm. You know, he's how much is he costing you there?
55.
5,500.
Oh, my.
Yeah, against Washington, I really think that's going to be a high scoring good old fashioned barn burner.
The no old defense. Fashioned piss fest.
Yeah, no defense allowed that game. No. I'm hoping. All right. So DK, you're tight end, sir.
Well, I like Benjamin Watson so much.
You're picking him too?
No, I'm going the other side of the ball. Reed. I want Jordan Reed because that New Orleans defense
is horrible. It is a dumpster.
That fire. Other Ryan brother down there.
Mm-hmm.
Why is he on a sideline jumping around with his big beard and belly going, yeah? How like what kind of defense are they running?
Fires him up.
Horrible, man. I might even go. I like Kirk Cousins in that game. I like everybody. Anybody throwing against New Orleans.
Defense. I love Lamp.
Are you really saying that, or are you just?
I love Lamp.
Okay.
Like,
all right.
Lamp. Lisa Lampanelli.
No, Lamp.
All right. So that's your tight end, and now what? What are we?
Now what? Well, we talk about the weather.
That's right. Let's go to TJ for the 5-day forecast.
Wind warning tomorrow, gentlemen.
Uh-oh.
High wind warning.
Lots of wind.
Lots of wind.
So if you're kicking outdoors.
On a Thursday night.
You got to speak into the mic. You're
me?
Yeah.
I don't
know. You're so far away.
I said if you're kicking into the wind.
Tomorrow?
Yeah. Wind. You playing football during the day?
The wind's in Buffalo. Oh, I'm just saying in case you have yard duty and you blow away.
That's what she said.
No, I'll be all right.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't blow away. It's got to be a strong one.
All right. So from tight ends to the first wide receivers, who are you picking for your first of three? TJ, let's go with you.
Well, this gentleman.
Well, there you are.
Gentleman.
Give me Amari Cooper, right?
Well, he might be one of the three. I don't know.
What gentleman are you going with?
The first gentleman I'm going with is the gentleman I went with last week.
Oh, boy. Hold on.
Who apparently his paws are the size of a Triceratops Rex. Alshon Jeffrey, again.
He's a monster, eh?
He just caught it. It was like he had stick-em on his hand.
Yeah.
Radar.
Yeah,
him and Cutler look good.
Yeah, that's the only thing. Well, I mean, what's his name there? Langford
was solid.
Wow, mm-hmm. Yeah. Definitely Duffy has been a point producer for him for the last couple of weeks, especially with Forte being out for God knows how long. Hopefully not too long. But all right, Mr. Alshon Jeffrey. DK, who are you picking with your first wide receiver?
Allen Robinson.
Ah, I was going to go Allen Robinson.
Thank you. I appreciate that one.
Yeah.
Baltimore's defense is ferocious.
You know what?
It
makes.
Come on, I stopped teaching and talking proper grammar.
It makes, it makes everything this much better though, because the shittier Baltimore gets, the likelihood of Harbaugh to Detroit gets better and better and better. Just remember that.
There you go. Always thinking positive.
Mm-hmm.
Always looking at the bright side.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right. Mm-hmm. So there's your first wide receiver for both of you. TJ, your second wide receiver, sir.
I am going no.
Ah, damn it.
You want me to say him too. Amari Cooper, right?
Is he going to be your third one?
No.
You cannot go a week without Amari Cooper.
No, because I'm going with the other guy, Crabtree.
Crabtree.
That's right.
Crabtree.
On that bitch-ass trick.
All right, Crabtree, how much is he costing you?
$6,400.
Oof.
He is a seal.
He's a seal? He's part of the Navy SEALs, right?
That's right. That's right.
The Oakland SEALs, I guess you want to call them. DK, you're a second wide receiver, sir.
Do I want to go with my expensive one or do I want to go with my cheap one? No, I'm taking Antonio Brown. I think.
Guess who?
Herbert the Pervert.
Is that Jackson? It sounded just like Jackson. Is that him?
Creamy thighs.
Oh, I'm sorry. So who are you going with?
No, I'm not repeating it. That was rude. It's a rude comment right there.
That's a rude comment.
I took Antonio Brown.
Ooh, Antonio Brown.
They're going against Cleveland.
I understand that, but with Big Ben out, big old...
Big Ben was out for the whole fourth quarter, and Antonio Brown, Landry Jones still hit him three or four
Landry
times.
Landry Jones, do you have enough faith that Landry Jones and Antonio Brown can recreate that chemistry?
I'm pretty much... I think my entire fantasy team is going to be Pittsburgh this week. Just, we're not done yet. You watch.
He's going to have everybody Pittsburgh.
Everyone. So I'm getting a little inside info coming to running back soon.
Oh, yeah. Lock
it
up.
Lock it up. All right. So we're going with downtown Antonio Brown. TJ, your next guy, please.
Well, I'm going to spend a little cash, but I don't want to spend a little cash.
No. Hey, big spender.
No, no. I'm going Randall Cobb against the Detroit Lions.
Oh, great pick, great pick. Anybody against the Detroit Lions.
Because I think this is the Aaron Rodgers at home. He is going to be pissed off. Might throw for 50 million yards.
Lost two in a row. Why not?
Yeah. And I don't know who's in the back in the backfield for
Jamie Stark. Jamie Lannister.
Jamie Stark, isn't that Jamie Stark, an ESPN reporter that does NASCAR for ESPN?
Oh, I don't know. James Stark.
Yeah, I heard today they were talking Lacey's way too fat.
Yeah.
Is that what they're saying?
He likes that chicken.
Said he's too big for that backfield.
Well, come to Detroit then.
All right. Yeah. Anybody, maybe. Yeah. Anyways, so you're going with corn on the cob, huh? Some little Randall Cobb. All right, DK, your third and final wide receiver as you make your selection.
Oh boy, this won't work out too well if I take him. Do I get to look ahead for a second? Oh boy. I can't take him. Man, I really screwed this up.
Oh, God.
Can I do that? Okay, hold on. What are we doing? Wide receivers?
Yeah.
Man, I don't want to go that far down.
Hey, don't drop that duck.
Oh, what the hell? I'll take Stephon Diggs.
Stephon Diggs, how much is he costing you?
I don't want to take Stephon Diggs.
Then don't.
Okay, good. I changed it. I'm going back to the same.
Wow.
I'm going back to the same guy I had last week because I think they're gonna have to use him.
Do you want that?
No, I don't want these nuts. I'm gonna take Tavon Austin again. One of these weeks, you guys are just picking on me this week. I feel like I'm getting bullied.
These nuts.
I mean, I'm only 2 weeks back. He's only beaten me twice more.
Dumbass.
Yeah. All right. So is that your final decision?
Yes.
So confident.
With a whole bunch of confidence.
So much confidence going in.
Yes.
All right. TJ, you got your three or you need to do one more?
No, I got three.
All right. Moving on. So just to recap quick, before we go to running backs, your wide receivers, TJ.
Alshon Jeffrey, Michael Crabtree, Randall Cobb.
DK, yours.
Allen Robinson, Antonio Brown, Tavon Austin.
Austin, all right.
Austin.
Moving on to running backs.
I think Cobb's going to get shut down by the Lions D this week.
Well, watch it, eh?
What's that guy, Josh Wilson, who can't shut down anybody? I think he's going to shut him down.
Josh Wilson, who couldn't shut the front door? He's going to shut him down?
He's going to shut him down? Well, hopefully he does. Yeah, either Randall Cobb's going to have a huge game or James Jones is going to have
a monster. Thank you. Thank you for that.
You're welcome. Hey, yeah. It's either one or the other. You either got to pick one or the other because you have no Jordan Nelson to come out your way. All right, running backs. DK, your running back, sir. Your first running back.
And Adrian Peterson.
Ooh.
I think I'm going to end up like TJ and I'm going to have to get a bench quarterback this week.
Laugh all you want.
I'm really, really struggling here. That's good money.
Oh, Adrian Peterson. Him in Oakland? Yeah. We'll see how he does on the West Coast over there.
Why not? I'm just hoping this guy has a big week. I don't want to take him, but whatever. Everything else, I'm trying to go opposite of what I usually think, because when I usually go with what I think, I get my ass kicked. The old
George Costanza method. I like that. All right. So, TJ, who do you got for your first wide running back? Sorry. It's a running back circus. Which one is he going to take?
DeMarco Murray. Philadelphia Eagles.
DeMarco. Loves him some DeMarco, huh?
First time I've taken him all year.
Ooh.
I like that pick. He's starting to be their number one.
They just say he's starting to. He's asserting himself.
He is.
He's healthy now.
Yeah. All right. We'll see. All right.
We'll see.
We'll see. I don't know. We'll see. You know what? I'm not too crazy about that pick, actually. So we'll see. Second running back, Mr. DK, as you play the drums.
Well, yep.
Yep.
I've got balls of steel. Well,
that sucks. What the hell's wrong with D'Angelo Williams?
Nothing.
Are you kidding me? He didn't practice today.
So he didn't practice today. I mean, they do that all the time.
I know, but it said he's got a bad foot.
He's got a bad wheel, eh?
Yeah, that really takes out of my let's pick everybody from Pittsburgh strategy.
Mm-hmm. I would take him anyway.
Well, go ahead. You can take him. TJ's out.
No, I'm not taking him.
You just said you'd take him.
For you. Speaking for you.
What are you, daily now? Mm-hmm. Trying to pick against me again?
Good evening.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, speaking of which, you guys still have your lifelines if you wish to use them.
Yeah, wish is a key word.
Yeah, we do, but we'll see how that goes.
Yeah, Daly's not around. It's different. It's just different when Daly's not around. Daly, we miss you, buddy.
Who else could I call
for? You got any, you know, that song Jimmy Kimmel plays, or Fallon? Oh. When he does, when he reads the, like sad music? When he writes the postcards?
Need, like, sad music?
Yeah.
Let's see here.
Do I have any phone of friends that I can use? Oh,
sad moment. Here you go.
There it is. Jason, why do you got to be in Pittsburgh tonight?
He's not in Pittsburgh. He's in Kansas City.
I mean, Kansas City. I'm just so worked up with Derrick talking about Pittsburgh all the time. I just can't get Pittsburgh off my mind.
It's understandable.
Play that again because I'm not done.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So, Daly, come back. We need to talk about our Pistons. Our 6-2 Detroit Pistons. Yes, Daly. We miss you. Come back. Okay, I'm done.
I'll try a phone a friend for fun.
Yeah, let's try.
I don't know who I'm going with, but let's see if this works.
This is for your running back, correct?
Apparently. I mean, if I pick a running back, then I don't have an excuse. If this guy picks my running back, then
well. You blame it all on him?
Yeah.
Pronto, chi parla?
Hello?
What's going on, Steve?
Nothing, what's up?
Steve.
Welcome to the podcast.
Oh, no.
You got your pop in your chair.
You said you wanted to be on it, so, yeah, so here you are.
Man, I'm on the podcast with the boys.
Yeah. I hope you studied up this week because this is a big decision for you.
And you cannot pick Randy Moss.
Oh, my God. Well, I just saw Ty Domi at Walmart, but I know that's a completely different sport at least.
I was there, too. Yeah. Did you get his autograph?
No, I didn't get it, but he was giving them out.
Yeah, you had to buy the book.
Literally giving them out, eh?
Pretty much just giving them out. Nobody was even around him. Just a random guy, random table.
No, that's not true.
That?
No. Hey, we should do the podcast from the club one time.
That'd be cool.
Yeah, relocation.
On location, you mean.
On location, not relocation. Yeah.
No, he meant relocating from here, though.
Oh, yes. That's right. Yeah.
Exactly. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks for clarifying.
What are you doing? You working in your basement?
No, I'm taking a break. Just went to Walmart.
Did you just hear that? He just said he's went to Walmart.
I thought that meant like earlier today.
No, it just meant right now.
Like literally right now?
I knew exactly what you meant, by the way.
Exactly. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Is that bringing back the days of when you used to stock shelves for Coca-Cola?
Pretty much. I went down the aisle. That looks like crap. But
did you try to fix it?
Fix it up a little bit.
Did you?
Bring that company back.
Yeah.
Oh, good for you.
So what do we got here?
You ready to make a few picks for me?
Yeah, let's hear it.
All right, so I'm going to give you two options. You're going to choose one, and it better be the right one.
Okay.
So, what teams do you like in football?
Who, me?
Yeah.
Tampa Bay Buccaneers. strictly because I like the logo. And,
well, at least you're honest.
Yeah.
D's nuts.
Yeah, whatever. Really, whatever team that Randy Moss was playing for at the time.
So that's Patriots.
So it's Patriots and
Vikings.
And the Vikings, strictly, that's it.
Wow, and that guy was Jets? Such a big pothead.
I thought he played for the Jets.
Yeah, well, you know.
Who, Moss?
Did Moss play for the Jets?
Oh, I don't think so. He played for Oakland.
Oakland.
Oh, Oakland, yeah. I didn't know that, actually.
Did you have a big black Raiders Randy Moss jersey?
Negative. I have Vikings one.
He had a big black starter hat coat, though, probably.
Did you have one of those black hats Raiders? With the metal on the front that said Raider?
No, definitely did not.
Mm. Oh, yes.
But if anything, I probably did have one of those puffy starter coats
that my parents
would have bought me.
The pullover with the pouch in the front?
No, maybe.
I had one of those.
Like the zip up.
I had a Philadelphia Eagles one.
I can almost guarantee that I had one of them from the Oakland Raiders. I'll pull up a picture. Vintage.
It's okay. We don't need the picture. I mean, how are we going to see the picture anyway?
Word to your mother.
Yeah, exactly. Word to my mother.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to Heidi.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
So what do we got?
Okay.
Bruh.
You got a lot of drops tonight. Darren's just crushing you with these drops tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Booyah!
Can you hear these drops, by the way, or no?
Who, me?
Yeah.
No, I can't.
Okay.
Yeah.
You're pretty dumb.
More reason for him to tune in.
There you go.
It's true. Okay, you ready? I'm going to give you two names.
Let's hear them.
It's interesting. One of the names I was going to give him is Buccaneer, but now I know for sure he'll take him, so I'm not going to give it to him. All right. We're going with Darren McFadden for the Dallas Cowboys, America's team, going against your Tampa Bay Bucks. Or D'Angelo Williams for the Pittsburgh Steelers.
I'm probably going to go with McFadden, and I don't know why I'm going to choose him. I feel like I've heard his name fairly recently, but I just don't like the Steelers that much for whatever reason. No, just don't like them. Somebody, you know, a couple people were on the bandwagon lately, but last year, and I don't like those guys that were there, so they like the Steelers. I hate the Steelers.
I just figured you were one of those, you'd be like Steelers, black and yellow.
Yeah.
No, not my thing. I do like rap music, though.
That's true. You're a big Hit the Quan fan now.
Mm-hmm. I love Hit the Quan. If I could only actually hit the Quan, maybe me and Quinn could hit the Quan at some point.
Maybe. You know what? I'm thinking you get your whole wedding party together and you guys just do that next year.
If it's simple, I could probably learn it. But
all you got to do, you just got to read the words. It's pretty much what it is.
I'm pretty sure all you got to do is get low and probably hit the quant.
Yeah. And then it's like there's a part where it's like, you know, throw a flag and you pretend you're throwing a flag and then like pop, 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 you pretend you're shooting a gun and that's about it.
Sounds about vintage classic gangster. Right.
So what are you up to tonight?
Don't worry about it.
Heading over to your brother-in-law's, just going to your house. What are you doing tonight?
I'm probably just going back to my house. Got to go stop on my parents. But other than that, really am I going to stop on my brother-in-law's? Please, I haven't been over there in months.
Just asking.
You should, though.
I should, I guess.
Mm-hmm. You should check out his new floors.
Did you finish your basement?
It's almost done. I just got to pour the concrete now.
Yeah. Did you get all the concrete out of the basement?
Nope. That's going to be a struggle. That struggle is real.
Darren said he'd give you a hand.
Yeah.
Yeah, I bet he, yeah. When it's just, you know, maybe give me a hand, you know, conveyor belting it up, and then it's going to go where? I don't know yet.
Well, you better figure that out.
Is that window open right there?
Yeah, I could open the window, but it's so small.
That's true.
But.
All right.
But anyways, I hope the pick does well. Let me know.
Oh, I will. Don't worry. I'll let you know either way. We'll figure something out.
All right.
All right, Steve. Thanks for the input.
Thanks, guys.
See you, man.
See you later.
Yeah, bye.
Bye.
There you go.
That was a waste of a fucking music pick.
All that for
so
who?
He said Darren McFadden. You have to play him now.
He's in. Of course I have to play him.
Wow. It's almost like
you're really hoping that he'd say D'Angelo Williams.
It was one of
Williams.
Those things where it was going to be like, I hate the Cowboys. You know, everybody likes America. Give me that. I was like, oh, son of a bitch.
All right.
You know, oh, they're playing the Bucks. That's my favorite team.
Yeah. Come on now. All right, so just recap your two running backs there, DK. I know.
My two running backs are Mr. Adrian Peterson against the Oakland Raiders, And Darren McFadden.
Mm. All right, TJ.
Water boy.
Your running back. Your second and final running back is...
You know, all this time I've been looking, and the running back situation is awful.
Uh-huh.
I'll be honest, it's quite awful. And I'm not paying $9,200 for Todd Gurley. That is not happening.
You know you want to.
No, I don't. And
you know what? I don't even like him this week. I think the Bears defense.
The Bears D is good. The front four is good.
Yeah, I think you know what? That's why I like Tavon Austin, because I think they're gonna have to do some outside running, maybe some passing. I think Gurley. I don't think this is the week he can run on his shoulders there, Darrin.
You know what? I didn't have to worry about him last week because Antonio Brown just tore up.
Yeah.
You know, so he did chip in with 15 points though, Todd Gurley. So I was thankful for that.
I'm not saying he's not going
to. No, I'm not expecting him to carry the load, because the guy I'm playing against, he's got Aaron Rodgers, Adrian Peterson. His team is just sick.
How old is this? How do you do this in yours? Is it just first come, first serve?
Yeah, apparently.
Well,
everybody just shows up.
Okay, I'm ready.
All right, okay. Hold on.
Amari Cooper.
Can I get Amari Cooper?
Latavius Murray. Someone from Oakland.
No. I'm actually...
I'm just trying to make this last. This could be our last week doing FanDuel.
Oh, yeah. Why? That's right.
Didn't you see the Canadian government's trying to shut it down now?
No way.
Yeah. They just got a hold and they're trying to...
Shut it down.
I need to do an appeal to play the sad music again.
Oh, sad music?
Yeah. Okay, here comes another appeal.
Hold on one second.
Nobody knows.
All right, here we go. Ready?
No.
Trouble. And...
Oh, hold on. Prime Minister Trudeau, you're going to legalize weed in about 4 minutes. Please don't shut down FanDuel. Because what else am I going to do on a Wednesday night?
Hashtag save FanDuel.
Hashtag save us. Please, Prime Minister Trudeau.
If you get rid of FanDuel, he has to force to play with his kids.
What would your father do in a situation like this?
Hashtag save FanDuel.
Hashtag what would Pierre do? Thank you.
Hashtag liberal smoke weed.
Smoke weed every day. Okay. All right. Speaking of smoke weed every day.
Oh, you're going with Randy Moss.
No, folks.
Straight cash.
Garrett Blunt.
Lock that in so then I can tell you what I heard on the radio today.
That's my thing.
That was
Lewis,
easy.
I don't know if he's even
Lewis
playing.
Is done. Lewis is on the IR.
Is he on the IR?
Yeah, he's done.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I wasn't sure if he was on the IR. I knew he was.
Yeah, put him on the IR because then I can tell you.
What?
That LeGarrette Blunt's probably not even starting this week. They're giving it all to Brandon Bolden.
Why?
They said that's the new Lewis, man. They said that's who they're going to run with.
Well, fuck him.
So, I don't know. You know what? I think it might be too early, but I heard if you're in fantasy, Darrin, buy him cheap, Bolden or Cadet.
Cadet?
If you're looking in the future, those...
Who's Cadet? Who does he run for?
Him and Bolden are the two, like, going to be the two. Like, Blunt's going to be their runner.
Don't they still have James White?
No. I don't know. But I was listening to a thing today, and they were talking about... what's his first name?
So just recap. Who are you taking again? I'm sorry?
DeMarco Murray and LeGarrette Blunt.
Smoke weed every day.
That's right.
Yeah. All right. Well, now we get to the fun part. Who's leading these teams this week? Obviously, with All In on the Rivers.
You got a lot of money left?
I got $8,800.
Ooh. How much money you got?
I got a guess. Can I pick? When you told me your money, I picked your guy like 3 weeks in a row.
Mm-hmm. Hold on. How much money do you have left, DK?
I'm at $7,300.
All right. Okay.
Ooh, Jesus. All
right. So obviously,
which works out good because two of the quarterbacks. This is where I should have used my phone.
You can still use it because
Tyrod Taylor, Mariota, but poo, Bradford.
All right. So we'll start with.
You're going Cutler.
We'll start with TJ.
Can I get Cutler?
No, you can
I
get
go,
Cutler.
I wouldn't go Cutler against that defense.
Hoyer?
All right.
Bobby Hoyer?
Brandon Hoyer, isn't it?
You're just throwing out every name I could possibly get.
You're going Cousins. You're going Cousins. dirty right. Man.
So, TJ, you're quarterback this week.
Mine?
Yeah.
I don't know. Who am I taking? He's going to pick it.
He's going to pick
He's
it?
He's wrong every
what, you
week.
You got 8,800?
Yeah.
Oh.
Who am I picking?
I got two that are options. And I'm thinking Monday night, Andy Dalton. Or you might like I don't think you're going to go spend all your money and take Drew Brees. I don't think you're going Cam Newton again. I'm thinking I like Dalton. And I'm thinking you might even surprise us and go with Blake Bortles.
Oh, you want me to do that special pick, eh? The Blake Bortles pick? Not taking Blake
Bortles.
I don't
think that's much special. That guy's been throwing the shit out of
the ball. He has been throwing the shit out of the ball.
Like, I mean, if I knew Hearns was actually going to play this week, I probably would have picked up Robinson and Hearns.
But
am I wrong with all of those? Like, I think it's one of two. Dalton or Bortles? And you said no to Bortles.
No.
So it's not Dalton either, eh?
No, Dalton's one of them. Oh, the red rifle.
But I don't think you're going to go Breeze, sorry, against
Washington. Well, no, those are my two.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. That's close. Wow.
Yeah. And I'm looking Washington.
You got so many options, though.
You like it, though. Me and DK can
see. If I had the money, you know who I really like this week? I like Eli Manning. I like him.
I think
he's going to come out fire and try. I think they want to beat New England. I think if New England loses, this is the week they're gonna in New York.
Really?
Yeah, I think... I don't know. I think Eli's going to have a big game. I don't think New England's even going to lose. I mean, I think they're ridiculous this year. I think they got that little, chip on the shoulder.
Extra motivation.
Oh, yeah. But I think if this is the week that they can lose, I think it's going to be a high scoring. It's going to be a tight game. And I think Eli's going to have a big week.
Wow. All right.
That's why I'm surprised neither of us won OBJ.
Yeah. Yeah.
No. No.
So.
All right. So who is it? Hold on, let me get you a drum roll so we can...
I got it.
Do a... Wow. Hold on.
Stafford?
Yep.
Keep $2,100 in a bank and go with Stafford. Go.
Yeah, you got the drum roll?
Ready?
Okay, ready? Go. Andy Dalton.
Yes! See, you know what? I like that because it leaves you a quarterback for Monday night. So when you're real far behind,
I don't think of that. You think of that all the time.
I don't think about it on my own. This fucking applause is going to be on for
I know. And he's clapping too.
Yeah.
I don't get it.
Extra whatever. Clap.
Okay, all right. The reason I always like it, and then this week I didn't even think about it, is my team's done at 1 o'clock.
Your whole team?
I think I have Adrian Peterson at 4. As of right now.
I got one, two, three.
I always like having that Monday night guy.
I got
guy
three
just,
at
just
4 and 8.
I do,
like
too.
Like your last bullet in the chamber.
Yeah, that's why this week was great when Rivers going. But, I mean, I'm sitting here and I'm like, oh, yeah, look at my team. 1 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 1 o'clock. Wow. I'm going to know whether I'm getting my ass kicked or I'm winning.
By 4 o'clock.
By 1:30.
Yeah. All right. You're going with the Red Rocket. DK, you're...
He just tipped his hand, eh?
I know. Yeah.
You tipped your hand.
You kind of did.
You said your whole team's done by 1 o'clock.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, when do these guys play? No, I have Adrian Peterson.
All right.
But, yeah, the two quarterbacks I'm considering are definitely.
Oh. All
right.
They'll be done by 1 o'clock, too.
So you're QB.
So going into the 4 o'clock games, I'm going to need Adrian Peterson to give me about 120 points.
Is that it?
That's a possibility.
That's good. Yeah.
All right. Oh, so many options. I mean, I got Tannehill, Stafford. The options are just endless. I mean, Nick Foles. I'm just like, wow. Who do I?
Herbert the pervert.
Guess who?
That almost sounds like my grandma when I first answer. She answers the phone. Hello.
Hello.
All right. So.
And it's gone.
She gone.
You're taking Cousins, aren't you?
It's Cousins or Landry Jones. Those are my two picks.
Oh my god!
Wow.
I think I could put them both in my lineup. Like I have enough money to buy both of them. Moment with 7,300.
Landry Jones is 4,000.
Let me see. What else do I got? There? You know who else? Oh. I think you went with him once too. Didn't you go with Alex Smith 1 week?
Yeah, because I had to. Because I had no choice.
What about Geno Smith? You think he's going to come back for a big week this week?
Oh, no!
All right. I guess if I have to pick, and it's got to be somebody under 7,300.
And if you have to pick, you have to pick.
I do have to pick. Well, I guess Kirk Cousins. Why not? Everybody else has thrown for 500 yards against New Orleans in the last 2 weeks.
Yep, exactly.
I mean, you got, what's it called? And we're back. I know you guys didn't know the delay, but Darren's power cord just shut off on the computer. And
I'm holding it in.
And we gone. So he's sitting over there with a little bit of duct tape, scotch tape, masking tape, and holding it in a certain position so we don't lose power.
Not moving my hand. So
I believe we just went with, I think I just went with my quarterback, and I ended up taking Aaron Rodgers.
No, you did not take Aaron Rodgers.
Shit. Kirk Cousins.
Herb Cousins. Herb is his cousin.
I took that for Darren because this is the week. This is the former Michigan State week.
That's right.
However, I'm pretty confident going against that other Ryan guy's defense because they can't stop anybody until this week, I'm assuming. But, yeah. So.
Okay. So just to recap your full teams. DK, go ahead.
I got to do this quick, right, because your hand's getting sore from holding the power
button. It's getting there.
Cousins, Peterson, McFadden, Robinson, Brown, Austin, Reed, Zerline, and the Steelers. And thanks to Steve, I think his license plate says Boner 19 or something like that.
Boners to Bone.
Boner? Bon? Bone? Bond? I don't know.
Wiener.
Boner. That's his pick, McFadden. Nice. But I like it. I like it, Steve. And yeah. I have $800. I want to go back and make a few changes, but we don't have time because Darren's holding the power cord.
Mm-hmm. Now, once you make your picks, that's your picks. That's it.
However, we are in discussions of changing that.
Okay. We'll change it next week. Mm-hmm. TJ, your team, quickly.
Dalton, Murray, Blunt, Jeffrey, Crabtree, Cobb, Watson, Gano, and the Eagles. Fly, Eagles, fly.
All right. So those are pretty good teams. My little conundrum, because Rivers is on a bye this week, I have to fill in a quarterback. So out of these three quarterbacks, who do I start
with? These nuts.
Derek Carr, Kirk Cousins, or Matthew Stafford?
I thought you were going to phone a friend, you said.
Doesn't have time.
With what hand?
Who was your phone a friend? You were pretty excited about this.
It was going to be our buddy Jimmy, but...
Jimmy.
We'll get him on next week. Next week's pod again.
Okay, what did you... You have Carr? Bradford?
No.
Bradford?
I had Bradford. I got rid of him.
Oh, bad, bad, bad. Bradford this week's going to be money.
Bad, bad, bad.
No, so I got Carr, Cousins, or Stafford.
So do we want you to win or we don't want you to win?
Well,
Stafford.
Carr.
Come on, you're a diehard Lions fan. Stafford.
No.
So you're a diehard Lions fan, you're a diehard State fan.
I'm in first place. I don't want to mess it up.
Carr.
Carr.
You're asking me. Look who I just picked.
I know. I shouldn't be taking your advice.
Hold on. You're going to go Carr at home against Minnesota's defense?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Or, I don't like it.
Or Cousins?
Murray is hurt.
What?
Latavius Murray is not 100% healthy, is he?
He's not 100% healthy.
No. He got a concussion last week.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter.
Well, it doesn't matter.
Okay.
I mean, the other two can't, so they are going to throw the ball, but Minnesota's defense is
pretty solid. Only saying Kirk Cousins because he picked Kirk Cousins.
No, Minnesota's defense is pretty solid.
They are.
It's pretty, yeah. Right. But they're not the best on the road, which kind of makes me, Anyways.
Then why are you asking us?
Because I want your opinion. I'd
go Cousins. Right. I go Carr.
Okay. The only reason I'd go Cousins is because New Orleans' defense is horrible, and I think they're going to be Washington can't run the ball, so they're going to pass. Yeah. And he's got short passes to Jordan Reed. You just said DeSean Jackson's going to have a monster week.
I hope he is. I got him on my flex. I mean,
if you're asking me, I like Cousins this week.
All right, boys. Well, another podcast is in the books. Hopefully you guys put up some big numbers, and hopefully, DK, you can get a win this week with your sweet, sweet lineups led by Darren McFadden.
Bam!
That's right. A rip.
That's a rip. All right, well, that's it for the Two Man Advantage podcast, Fantasy Football Edition, and we'll see you guys next week.
See you later.
Peace.